Hello everyone, Murray here. I'm at the Tyranosaurus Rex Discovery Center. I'm going to narrate some of this video because of windy and poor audio. It's near Eastend, Saskatchewan, as you can see on the map here. Let's go in and check this out and see what it's all about. This is our tour guide. Her name is Kelsey, and she's going to tell us about Scotty the Tyrannosaurus Rex.
So the first T-Rex we have on display here is Scotty. So Scotty's the local Tyrannosaurus Rex discovered and was found about 30 kilometers southeast of current location. Scotty was originally discovered in the year 1991 by Mr. Robert Gephardt, who at the time was actually the high school principal. What happened was he was walking along a cow trail and he happened to look down and he found a fossil. A couple steps later, he found another one. Unfortunately, at the time of discovery in 1991, there was a couple other dig sites open here in Saskatchewan. So what this meant for Scotty's fossils was there wasn't enough paleontologists to open another dig site. So the dig site didn't open until the summers of 94 and 95 with some of the first excavations uncovering the floor jaw area in 2018. Now, if you clearly guess to what this is?
Dino dung.
Correct, it is dino dung. It's fossilized dino dung, and the technical term is coprolite. This particular piece is found about a mile away from Scotty's quarry site. And the way we can tell it's from a meat-eating dinosaur, well, there's two different ways, really. One's the size, flat shape, it's fairly large. The second are those little brown flecks in there. And what those are fossilized bone chips within the dung. What happens is large meat-eating dinosaurs, say like T-Rexes, didn't really have teeth meant for chewing their food. They pretty much just ripped it apart and swallowed and whole bone, flesh, everything. During the digestion process, not all the bone pieces would be broken down fully, and a lot of the times, little chips would become waste. That's what those are. On the back wall there, that's a life-size mural of a T-Rex. They range from roughly 20 feet in height to about 40 feet in length, and it could reach speeds up to 40 kilometers per hour, which is pretty fast for something that big. Now, a T-Rex had a life expectancy of about 30 years, so that's not much compared to some modern-day reptiles. However, for something that large that existed about 65 million years ago, 30 years could have been a long time to live. Especially with the type of lifestyle they had to have lived. It was ultimately survival of the fittest, eat or be eaten. This line right here, this is what we call the KT boundary. The KT boundary was formed when an asteroid hit in the Yucatan Peninsula, creating a crater of 180 kilometers in diameter. So as this asteroid hit, dust and debris rose into the air, creating a nuclear winter. Also upon impact, it started wildfires. Ultimately, what this line is made up of, depending on where you are, is shock quartz, ash, and iridium. Now, ash is from the fires. Shock quartz is similar to the normal quartz. Iridium, however, is the odd guy out. Iridium is not a natural characteristic of Earth unless you find it contained within this line. It's actually a main component of things such as asteroids and meteorites. No matter where you go in the world today, this line is there. It's just in some places it's more visible than in others. Below is the dinosaurs and above the mammals. There's never been a dinosaur fossil discovered above the KT boundary.